My name is Christoph Galle. I'm from Marburg University in Germany. I'm working as an assistant professor at the Department of Church History. And today I gave a talk about Mary Magdalen in Carolingian, that is, of course, early medieval sermons and homilies. And I did it together with a colleague from Oxford, and we wanted to concentrate in our panel about the persistency of sanctity of Mary Magdalen. How did it change? What motives were conveyed in sermons and homilies? And this is a part of my second book project, which will be finished this autumn, so in a couple of months. And I'm working there on the Carolingian sermon collections that are model collections ordered by the secular or ecclesiastical elite of the Frankish kingdom. And all these sermons were used for preaching at any occasions within the church year. And it was a law given by the councils of the empire and by the empire himself that preachers all over the kingdom should only use sermons from these collections, so that they want to prohibit that people, preachers, preach on their own, because that sometimes caused heresy or wrong doctrines and so on. And Mary Magdalen was our topic today. It is an example out of these sermon collections. It's a very important example because she was presented as a prior sinner who then changed her life, became a prominent saint because she was the first woman coming to the grave of Christ, realizing that it was empty, and got the job given by the angel to tell Christ's disciples that Christ is risen. This is very important within the New Testament, but also within the sermons of the early Middle Ages, because it shows that you can change your life, that all the sins can find an end, and you have the possibility to get eternal life. That was especially in the Frankish Empire very important, because a lot of pagans were just Christianized, new Christians, and they all need to be taught how to live their life, how to deal with prior sins, with vices, and they tried to tell them the possibilities of change and the necessity of virtues.